This is your boy Ben back again on another video. This time on ECR. Why? Because I stay here. I've moved from the city about 30 kilometers from where I used to stay. Quite far, yes. Super duper far. This is the outskirts of the city. I mean, there's no more city after this. So, technically, very, very far off from where I used to stay. I mean, I used to long to come to these places. Every weekend, I would just want to just... I would just do anything to get to ECR and, you know, jump into the ocean and do things. I mean, just have fun, just not relax. This is inspiring for me. For many it is relaxing, for me it is inspiring, inspiring landscape. What I plan on doing now is I'm going to be checking out a place. I just zoomed into Google Maps and just was, you know, trying to look for some nice off-road spots, and here I am, lucky me. There's one right around the corner. Rocks, 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 rocks. One has to be really, really careful when you encounter rocks. There you go. That's all there is to it. Nothing more. That's the thing with off-road. Just comes to an end like that, you know? No more dry patches of land. Or... well, this is the reason why I ride an adventure motorcycle. Predominantly because I can just do this. Get in anywhere and do some figuring out. There seems to be a way. This is next to impossible with other motorcycles. Whoa! Ho ho! Look at where I am at. We'll explore this. We'll definitely check this out some other day. For now, back to where we came from. So, back on some fun landscape. Woo! So, this is the reason why you get yourself an adventure bike. Just about a minute ago, I was on the main road trying to figure my way out. And now here I am. A change of landscape, a change of mood, a change of air, a change of just about every single thing that causes suffocation. Yep, so it's only after I got the Himalayan, I started thinking about adventure riding as a concept. But before that, I would ridicule adventure motorcycles. I mean, the way they look. Honestly speaking, even though I'm a big admirer of the Royal Enfield Himalayan, I love its looks, and I've spoken in great detail about the same. I used to ridicule industrial-looking motorcycles. For that matter, motorcycles where there's a lot happening, too many parts sticking out, there's no cohesion as such. All of the components don't come together to make it look like one unit. I was a big hater of that. But then, now, after I got myself the Himalayan, riding every day on all sorts of terrain, it just completely educated me on how fantastically nice this concept is. To be cruising with other motorcycles on the highway, and then the moment you spot something interesting, the moment you spot something out of the box, you have the capacity to do it now, to execute it. It's an adventure motorcycle. You can just about go ahead and do it and see for yourself if things work. I mean, that is the best thing about an adventure motorcycle, if you ask me. This helps you live the life of an adventurer. That's not the case with race bikes. That's not the case with dedicated touring machines. That's not the case with any dedicated category as such. Only with adventure bikes, there is a possibility of doing things like this. Just a minute ago, I was on the roads, and now here I am. The transition is so seamless. It's just so seamless that it is remarkably amazing. The way you shift from one mode of riding to another mode is just butter smooth. There is no friction, there's no drama, there's no nothing. And a motorcycle like this just educates you. Hello. Before I have a visitor. Hello. Before I had the Himalayan, I had a Continental GT. And the Continental GT would be the last bike that I would bring here. Hello. I've made some friends. What's your name, fella? Don't have nothing for you. Nothing to eat. We'll figure something out tomorrow. Any which ways. So where was I? This fellow seems a little too friendly. I got this to learn what adventure riding is all about. I got this to do things that I hadn't done before. To try my skills on off-road terrain. I was a hardcore road rider. I have never even thought of taking my motorcycles off-road, and the very thought of taking my motorcycles off-road was nothing short of a nightmare to me. So, and every single time I took my motorcycles off-road, 90% of them failed. They had issues with suspension leaking. 90% of it was to do with suspension and related components. The engine, of course, is the same, but then again, this engine is one unique piece of art, I would say. Low down torque, tractoring just about anything, doesn't intimidate you, teaches just about anyone how to go off-road, how to do these things. And if you're committed to learning with this machine, this is the best beginner bike. This is the best out there in the market that can teach you how to do really tricky stuff without complaining. So that is why I got myself the Himalayan, and all my learning is all that I share on my YouTube channel. Apart from fixing the motorcycles business, whatever else that you see me doing with the Himalayan is me doing it live, learning it and putting it across to you as and when. So if there are fellows out there who do things a zillion times better than me, kudos to you. All the respect in the world to you. Would love to learn from you. And to all the fellows who are learning from what I do, please continue to follow me. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't. I will continue to put out valuable information. And yep, that's it. This is Ben on another fantastic, quick, short exploration ride of sorts. And yep, now headed back home. So we'll see you guys in a minute.